There is little in this world that I love more than performing live. From the first time I hit the stage when I was 14 years old, performing in a mall, and throughout my entire career, there's nothing that brings me more joy because I get to connect with my fans, that I get to perform with my bandmates and my best friends, and it's just really a magical experience that unfortunately a lot of us don't get to do right now. So we're all having to get a little creative, which is a good thing. And so I know that I've seen live streams, acoustic performances, and all kinds of, you know, different things like Doja Cat. She's doing these more elaborate, you know, setups for her performances. And so it's been kind of cool to see what everyone's doing across the board. And because we don't really know the future, what's gonna happen, I figured today I would share what I've been seeing online, but also talk about the future of live music. Hi guys, I'm Miss Krystle. I'm an entertainment attorney, public speaker, and author of How to Keep Your Dukes Up in the Music Business. I'm the owner of Dukes Up Records, and most importantly, I'm an independent musician. So the pandemic hits, wipes out the entire touring industry in pretty much the course of a couple of days when things really started ramping up. And then the entertainment industry and the music industry kind of just all fell shortly thereafter. And so thus far, I know that there's talk of some people trying to get back out and do shows by the end of the year. But quite frankly, I'm reading that, you know, the expectation is that for large gatherings, large shows, you know, it's not going to happen until maybe end of 2021. We'll see what actually ends up happening, but that's kind of what I've been reading thus far. So in the meantime, musicians have to figure out what to do to A, not lose their minds, because we all need to perform, but B, also just stay current. Musicians are still putting out music and just trying to connect with their fans. And so, like I said in the beginning of the video, I'm seeing things like live streams, acoustic performances. And even in the live stream department, I know that Post Malone just did a show a couple weeks ago, and this was a collaboration with some different musicians, including Travis Barker, drumming for him, and they did a Nirvana set. It's cool because it's like, for that kind of thing, when would you be able to see that in any other situation? Not only is this a free event that you get to live stream from, you know, your home, but also, you know, everyone's in more casual kind of attire. I guess actually they were wearing more dresses. Casual nonetheless. But, you know, it's just, it's a very unique time that we have the ability to even do that. And then on, you know, the more laid back for, you know, let's say smaller musicians who don't really have a great setup, they use their phone, do an acoustic set, just do something to stay active and current and connected with your fans. And even for my own project, we're setting up and recording performances, you know, live or from, you know, sessions in quarantine, and just doing it to share not just our own rehearsals, but to continue to promote music and to release a song at a time, especially if you have any newer songs that need to kind of be promoted. So there's creative ways to kind of still stay relevant and on top of the live performance element of our careers. Another example comes from Denmark, and there's a musician that goes by Mads Langer, and he did an outdoor show. So they built a stage and he basically invited his fans out via their cars. So basically it was like a drive-in concert, and the way people were able to listen is that they were directed to tune into a certain FM channel, and so then they could listen and watch and be a part of the event. Now logistically, I have my questions about exactly how that worked, whether there were like drinks served, are there restrooms nearby, how does that whole thing happen when you need to now leave? But nonetheless, the event was very successful and it looked pretty cool. And then on the other hand, you have Germany that is hosting outdoor drive-in raves. Now, the pictures that I've been seeing are super cool and they're very organized looking, so I kind of like that for my kind of curiosity about how you exit these events. But in any case, they're having them, they seem successful, and as someone who used to be in the rave scene, that's pretty cool. So I hope to see some of that kind of happening more here in the US, so we can all go out, have a good time, but stay safe. And I also mentioned at the beginning of the video, you have artists like Doja Cat, and she's doing these really cool, more elaborate sets where you see, there's basically, she's in like a cat house, right? There's the pink all over the place, and she's kind of, you know, cooing around and slithering and just looking beautiful. And that's a lot of fun. So you can do something like that. That really would be pretty low budget. Get the set, get maybe one or two you know, camera guys, and then they just cut B-roll in between the performances. So there's ways to still get out there, you know, work within a budget, be safe so that you don't have to be around, you know, a large group of people. But just make sure that you are still kind of honoring that piece about being a live musician and not losing that, because realistically, a lot of us are not going to be able to get back out to perform for a while. And like I said at the beginning of the video, there's a good chunk of us who will just not want to from a safety standpoint. So this is what we can do in the meantime. Now, I'd be remiss not to, of course, mention that while we're all planning our big, you know, comebacks with live shows, I do have a section in my book all about live shows and, more importantly, things like your merch and trying to sell and that kind of thing. So once we start getting a little bit closer to getting back out to performing, this is something that we all need to kind of get, you know, back into the groove with. So don't get too far away from your practicing. Make sure that you still are keeping yourself on track, because there will be a time that we need to get back and perform. And hey, it could be sooner than we think. Guys, I know some of you are probably super bummed out right now because you just want to get out. And especially if you're like a touring musician, it's your entire livelihood. Don't get bummed out. Figure out ways to stay active, stay positive. And, you know, even with things like social media, come say hi to me on social media. I'm on every platform, but like Instagram is the best way to get in touch with me. And let's just stay positive and keep feeding each other that motivation, because again, it's just a matter of time before we're back in action and everything's gonna be okay. We release videos just like this once a week to help you with your music careers and getting you to the next level. We talk about everything from music marketing to trademarks and copyright and everything in between. If you haven't, make sure to subscribe. Don't forget to turn on those bell notifications so you get notified every time a new video from your new favorite redhead goes up. I'll see you guys on the next one. I'm Miss Krystle. Bye.